Hello, YouTube, and welcome back.
Although just a handmaiden, she has Marjorie Tyrell's favor. And Lady Marjorie's betrothal to the king may be enough to keep the Boltons at bay. If it's presented to her as it should be.
So this is Mira of House Forrester. And we are back. So we're in King's Landing, the Snake's Nest. And this is episode 3 of Game of Thrones. Actually, it's episode 1, but part 3 of Game of Thrones, if you know what I mean. And thank you for your support and comments. The previous videos have done pretty well. It's great to know that people are enjoying this series. So let's continue. Dusty old tome. Let's have a look at this.
Wonders Made by Man by Lomas Longstrider. A gift from Roderick. I hope to see them all someday.
So, I am. Looks like I'm a servant or handmaiden to Marjorie Tyrell. I got the whole Tyrell kind of outfit going on. Which is kind of cool, kind of nice. I dig it.
King's Landing. I wonder if it's sunny at Ironwrath today.
Looks like she's missing home. It's a long way from the north. Ooh, letter from Mother.
It troubles me to even ask this of you, but you must appeal to Lady Marjorie to intervene on our behalf. She is our best hope, and can be a powerful ally, especially now when your family so desperately needs her help.
Ooh. Knock, knock. Who's there? Better go to the door. Don't think there's anything else I need to do. No, just the door. Coming!
One moment.
Oh, sorry, m'lady. I didn't mean to disturb you. I can come back later if you'd like.
Ah, shit. Let him in.
No, it's fine.
He looks poor.
Come in.
Let him in. What's he doing?
Begging your pardon, m'lady, but you all right?
Yep.
If you don't mind my asking, you seem rather upset.
Ah, shit. Tell me I'm worried.
I'm just worried about my family.
Ah, letter from home, is it?
It's kind of you to ask.
Of course, m'lady. You've always been kind to me.
Oh.
Please hurry if you can. Lady Marjorie will be here any minute.
Of course, m'lady.
Yeah, piss off. Basically. That's what she's trying to say.
You work for Lady Marjorie?
Yeah. Can't you tell by the outfit, you dumb fuck?
I may be wrong.
That's cruel of me.
It seems like you do.
I knew she was a handmaiden before
I'm her handmaiden.
Before they even said.
That's what I thought. I've seen you with her before.
You
seem
outfit
like
from the
good
show.
Friends. I saw Lady Marjorie just this morning, outside the Royal Sept, talking to Queen Cersei.
Cersei?
Uh-oh.
They appeared to be having some sort of disagreement. I couldn't hear much, but it was definitely an argument.
What did they say?
I couldn't make out much, but I know they were talking about the Starks and House Forrester.
House Forrester?
She doesn't know the dead,
I hope you're not in any kind of trouble. But I thought you ought to know.
I'm guessing.
Most people don't tend to notice a call boy. Not in King's Landing, with so many lords and ladies about. You see and hear all sorts of things when people don't even know you're there. Good night, m'lady.
Dismissed. What a nosy little boy. Hey, there she is.
Lady Marjorie, you're early.
I was hoping there would be time for us to talk. Come, there's something we must discuss. From the day you arrived in Highgarden, I've thought of you more as a friend than as my handmaiden. A dear friend, in fact.
Thank you, my lady.
And you know how I feel about what's happened to your family. I feel your pain as if it were my own. What you've suffered is beyond imagining. And your poor family as well.
My family wrote me, my lady.
I don't doubt they must be overcome with grief. But you must not despair. we will get through this together. You must understand there are limits to what I can say, especially here in King's Landing, now that I am to be queen. To have a handmaiden from the north whose family fought for Robb Stark, it raises questions at a time I can least afford.
You've got a point.
Cersei herself cornered me this morning outside the Royal Sept. She mentioned the northern girl in my service, and she painted you a traitor.
Oh, God.
She was very pleased with herself.
Oh, shit. Silence.
Her face was full of mirth as she said it.
Best say nothing.
I told her you are one of my most trusted handmaidens, that you can hardly be blamed for the actions of your father and brother. Nonetheless, she demands an audience. She wants an apology of some sort, for what I don't know, but she's waiting for us now, and I promised I would bring you to her.
Oh, shit.
I wouldn't ask this of you if it were not important. I cannot afford any conflict with Cersei with the wedding so near.
I'll do as you ask, my lady.
I don't want to get in trouble.
I knew I could trust you.
It's best to stay on Marjorie's side.
Tell her what she wants to hear.
Yeah, tell her what she wants to hear. So, we're going to be...
See if the Queen Regent is ready to receive us. You'll be fine. I know you will. You may feel one thing, but you must say another.
She's teaching me the game. The Game of Thrones. How to lie.
Good luck.
Good luck. Oh, I see Tyrion. And the Iron Throne.
You can do this.
Oh, I gotta walk. I'm in control. Don't kill me, please. I'm a beautiful young lady that wants to get married one day.
Ah, Lady Marjorie. Aren't you looking lovely this evening?
Lord Tyrion. Your Grace? With your permission, allow me to introduce Lady Mira of House Forrester.
Kneel before her.
Your Grace.
Yes!
The girl knows her courtesies. Impressive. You may rise.
Oh, God.
House Forrester is a northern house loyal to the king.
Are they?
I beg your pardon, Your Grace.
I wasn't talking to you. I want to hear from the girl. Is your family loyal to the king?
Perhaps you should ask the new Lord Forrester.
He's not here, is he? She is.
Joffrey is the one true king, Your Grace.
And yet... For centuries, the Forresters have been loyal bannermen to House Stark, a house of traitors.
They were our wardens.
They were the wardens of the North. We all served at the pleasure of the king.
Clever girl.
Yes.
Perhaps too clever for her own good.
The girl did name Joffrey as the one true king.
Is your house willing to swear fealty to your new liege lord, Roose Bolton?
He is the new warden.
He is the warden of the north, Your Grace.
He is. And I the Queen Regent and Tyrion the Master of Coin.
The girl has a remarkable talent for answering questions while in fact saying nothing at all.
Old allegiances are not easily abandoned, but now that the war is over, we must look to rebuild and forge new alliances. There are ships and shields to be built, and Joffrey will need a steady supply of ironwood for his armies. I'm told there are others who would happily serve that purpose, but I trust we can rely on House Forrester.
Forrester Ironwood does seem rather unique.
Yes, Your Grace.
Oh, shit.
It would be a shame to see it fall into the hands of another house. I imagine you'd do almost anything to prevent that from happening, wouldn't you? Ask any Lannister, and they'd do whatever was necessary to save Casterly Rock. It would be unfortunate to see another house lay claim to what's yours.
I won't dishonor myself, Your Grace.
I see.
What would you have the girl do, Cersei? It's not as if she fought beside the Starks, wielding a battle axe for the Northern Army.
It raises an interesting question, I suppose. Can we truly blame those who end up on the wrong side of the wall? Our dear Margaery here was betrothed to Renly Baratheon on the false assumption that he would one day rule the Seven Kingdoms. Can we fault her for her mistake? Should she be held accountable?
I won't judge her, Your Grace. I wasn't there. I didn't face her decisions.
Aren't you a delightful girl? If only one could flit through life without ever holding an opinion of their own.
If there's a point to this, I hope you find it quickly.
And doing so well dodging
bullets. Loyalty can be such a hard thing to define. This city alone is filled with all sorts of ambitious opportunists looking to reinvent themselves, pretending to be something they're not. Who knows what lurks within their hearts? You are a girl from the north here in service to Lady Margaery. One can only assume her interests are yours. Yet loyalty to a king, that must be absolute, beyond question. And if your loyalties were to become conflicted between your king and the very person whom you serve, what would you do then?
I'm sure she would...
Let the girl answer the question. Go on.
I must choose Margaery, Your Grace. I serve at her pleasure.
Clearly your handmaiden does not have her priorities straight.
She is a threat to the crown, isn't she? The most dangerous handmaiden in all of King's Landing.
Oh, shit.
I'm not quite sure what to make of her. Not surprising, I suppose, for a northern girl. But not very encouraging either. I'd like a word with you, if I may.
Of course, Your Grace.
I don't know if I've done well. I'm a bit concerned.
I'll walk you out. This may come as a surprise, but I met your father once, at the tourney at Lannisport. Even then he didn't trust Roose Bolton. We only spoke briefly, but your father struck me as an honorable man. You have my condolences for his loss. These would be trying times for your family, even under the best of circumstances.
These are trying times, my lord. My family fears what might happen now that the Boltons rule the north.
They must still answer to the crown. You shouldn't forget that, nor should they. You were brave to declare your loyalty to Lady Margaery. No doubt she was pleased, but Cersei, she will not soon forget what you said. It was quite the first impression. I, of course, found it all highly entertaining.
I don't particularly like her.
That was fairly apparent to everyone. My sister and I have our differences. She takes great pleasure in her little charades. I take mine in thwarting them. We must find our amusements where we can. She threatened to give your ironwood to another house. It is the master of coin who decides such matters. The crown needs boats. Boats need wood, and I speak for the crown in this regard, not her.
What are you suggesting?
I suppose the crown could be persuaded to secure ironwood from House Forrester. Lady Margaery might not look favorably on such an alliance, and it would infuriate Cersei. Although, what would be amusing for me might prove rather dangerous for you and your house.
Uh-oh.
Are you willing to risk that?
Oh, shit. Decision time.
It may be far too dangerous. In fact, forget I even suggested such a thing.
I'm sorry, Lord Tyrion.
Nope.
But it's a risk I cannot afford.
I admire your discretion. Now, if you'll excuse me, I promised Sansa I would join her for dinner tonight. 3 beautiful bottles of Dornish wine await my arrival. The mere thought of them makes me thirsty already.
I hope we meet again.
Nothing would make Cersei happier. Until then, be careful. This is not the North.
Oh, don't I know
it. King's Landing can be a nest of vipers to the uninitiated.
I hope I made the right choice not taking him up on that offer. Time will tell.
Mira, I was worried. How was it? Cersei has a way of looking at you as though you're nothing. It went well. Really? That's a relief. Cersei is known for being rather difficult. Lady Marjorie has spent the entire day working on seating arrangements for the wedding. Of course, you and I are seated way at the back, here with the fourth cousins and the ninth-born sons. Ah, Sir Jamie, I wouldn't mind tarnishing that white cloak of his.
Sarah, what?
It's
oh,
true.
Oh, yeah. A little bit of the Kingslayer.
And Oberyn Martell, the Red Viper. I'm told he has a paramour.
Oh, my God.
He is quite handsome
and quite passionate. From what I've heard. Perhaps Lady Marjorie could make the right introductions. Who knows? We might meet our future husbands.
Oh, yes.
Although, marrying a king, I can only imagine what that would be like. Would you marry Joffrey if it meant you'd become queen?
Oh, shit, that's a question.
He does have a certain look about
Not
him.
Joffrey.
And he's always treated Lady Marjorie well.
I'd be willing to marry, but not Joffrey.
Well, I would marry him. Imagine the power you would have as Queen of the Seven Kingdoms. I might even allow you to be my handmaiden. Let's see, who else should we marry off? Brienne of Tarth and Tyrion Lannister. What a perfect match!
That is quite funny.
Sir Bronn and...
What are you doing?
Uh-oh.
Well? Sarah?
I'm sorry, my lady.
As am I. We shouldn't have been messing about.
This is not a game. It's a battle plan. Allies and enemies can be made with every move. Yet they say it is men who are powerful.
Oh yeah, girl power.
The Queen was rather disappointed by your display, Mira. I'm just glad it's over. King's Landing can be exhausting sometimes. There's always someone to please or some perceived slight to smooth over. I fear it will only get worse when I am Queen.
Once they know your true heart, the lords and ladies will have no choice but to love you.
Do you agree?
People are not always so easy to please. If you showed Cersei your true heart, she would stab it with a fork.
You learn very quickly. Your words to Cersei were brave, but I know you must fear what the Boltons might do to your family. I do appreciate your willingness to appease her, as difficult as it may have been.
Thank you, my lady. There's been something on my mind. Something important.
Ask her for help.
I did have a favor to ask of you in return.
Whatever you wish to say, you can say it in front of Sarah. There are no secrets between us.
It's about my family.
I trust her.
Oh, shit. Is this good or bad? She can stay. I don't know if this is good.
Go on. Ask.
Can you stop Ramsay?
Please, Ramsay Snow is on his way to Ironwrath to see my brother bend the knee.
Ramsay? Roose Bolton's bastard.
I fear my family will suffer if Ramsay is left to do as he likes. But if a raven could be sent to the Boltons to let them know House Forrester has the protection of the crown...
That is no small request, especially now.
Uh-oh.
Joffrey knows only too well your family fought for the Starks. And now you would have me ask him to intervene. Is the situation that dire?
You can't, my lady. King Joffrey won't like it. Just think how he turned on Lady Sansa. I will forever be in your debt.
I shouldn't have asked
my
it to stay.
Will forever be in your debt.
I don't know, Mira. If Cersei were to find out...
You're adored by the king.
Don't let the queen bully you. You have power over him, Lady Marjorie, as no one else does. Not even his mother. Ramsay Snow will arrive at Ironwrath within the week. I would never ask this of you if it weren't so urgent.
Very well. I'll make your request, but I cannot promise anything.
Thank you, my lady.
Yes.
I will send a raven to my family at once.
Oh, this is going to be hard.